In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create a bouncing fake 3D sphere with 2D layers. Hey everyone, my name is Manuel. Let's dive right in. In After Effects, you can come pretty far pretending something is done in 3D, when in reality, it isn't. It's all about the textures, the lighting, and the shadows. I've created this background here. It's a solid with a gradient ramp. The brighter color towards the top right corner, meaning that's where the light comes from. On top of that, two simple text layers. And on top of that, a yellow solid with an ellipse mask and a huge mask feather. Around 900 pixels, which simulates shining light and brings the text layer and the background together. You want this layer to be on top of the layer stacking order. Well, almost. Above that, I always add a tiny bit of noise, like 3 to 5% or so no color noise. It reduces color bending and makes everything look more cinematic. All right, the sphere. With no layer selected, we choose the ellipse tool and double click on it to create a new shape. We open the ellipse path property and set the size to 200 by 200 pixels. That's the size of the sphere when it is on the background. This is the new property window, by the way, that came with the latest update of After Effects. You can access all properties directly from here now. Let's make this round shape look like a sphere. We don't need a stroke. And instead of a solid color, we choose a radial gradient for the fill. Let's open the gradient editor and change the colors. On the left, a very bright yellow. On the right, a very dark purple. Both colors are related to the background color, so you need to stick to your overall color theme. It's yellow, red, and purple in my case. Then we adjust the start and end of ramp by moving these two blue handles. The bright color needs to point towards the top right corner, where the light comes from. The dark color, the opposite direction. Now bear with me, I need to say this quickly. A lot of you are worried about AI taking over motion design. And it won't if you won't let it. AI will never be able to bring your very unique and creative ideas to life. It will never be able to replace your own very personal style. So it is more important than ever to know your craft. AI will help you though, in the process of creating stuff. But it will never be able to add the character and personality and nuances to your work that make the difference. The same is true for expressions, by the way. AI will help you to write complicated expressions. But it makes mistakes. It is only kind of human, right? So how will you be able to correct these mistakes if you don't know anything about expressions? With expressions, you can create transition rigs, for example. Use expression controls to quickly adjust them and use them as templates in Premiere Pro. I know this is overwhelming at the beginning. That's why in my new course, we start from zero. In 30 lessons, we go through the basics. Basic expressions, responsive animations, dynamic text animations, and repetitive techniques. Plus, I add new bonus content every month. You will create animations that wouldn't be possible without expressions. Enroll now and learn how to animate with expressions in After Effects. All right, back to our sphere. To add more details, we use layer styles. Let's name it, first of all, sphere. We right-click on the layer, go to layer styles, and choose inner glow. Let's open the property and adjust some settings. Blend mode, overlay. We choose a bright yellow again as color. Set the size to around 12. This adds some light and reflection to the edge. Then we add one more layer style. We open the menu again and choose Bevel and Emboss. We adjust some settings, Style, Inner Bevel, Technique, Smooth. Size 135, Soften 16. Angle 55 degrees. We want to take the light direction into account. Altitude 30, highlight color white, shadow color purple. Awesome. To make it convincing, one important thing is missing though, the shadow. we move the layer below the light in the layer stacking order and duplicate it. Name the bottom one Sphere Shadow. We delete all layer styles and add a drop shadow effect instead. It's in effect and perspective. I prefer the effects and presets window to find it. Opacity 75, direction 230 degrees. It points away from the light. Distance 10, softness 20. The shade is pretty hard and close. We duplicate it, set the opacity to 50%, distance 30, softness 75. The second layer is more distant and softer. We duplicate this effect, set the opacity to 35%, the distance to 80, and the softness to 100. And all three effect layers make the shade look natural. And finally, we need to link the shadow to the sphere. Once we got the style right, we need to animate it. Let's open the position and scale property. That's all we need. Let's move the sphere to the first position it hits the ground, which is around here, the bottom left part of the S. At 5 frames, let's add a keyframe for the position and scale. Then at the beginning, we scale it up to 260%. And move it out of the screen. Then we move on to 9 frames. And move the sphere to the right onto the letter P. And scale it up to around 140%. It bounced back up in the air. Then we go to 13 frames. Move the sphere to the right onto the left part of the H. It's on the ground again. Scale 100%. At 16 frames, we move it further to the right. We scale it up to 115%. Finally, at 19 frames, it hits the ground again, between the H and the E. And we set the scale back to 100%. Over time, the distances between keyframes get shorter. The distance the sphere travels gets shorter, and the scale values get smaller. Then, at 2 seconds and 16 frames, we move the sphere somewhere to the right of the E. It comes to a standstill there. Let's select the position property and open the graph editor. Make sure the speed graph is selected. And you should see steps like these. You can see the speed of the sphere. It is highest at the beginning, decreasing with each step until the sphere rolls out. First of all, let's slow down the end of the animation. We drag the point down and pull the handle to the left. Then we move that left point up until it snaps to the upper point. Activate snap if you haven't yet. Alright, it feels quite good overall. These yellow points are the position keyframes. If we move them and change the distance the sphere moves between two keyframes, we change the speed of it. We adjust the positions of the keyframes until the movement feels right. Finally, we need to animate the shade. The shade is there whenever the sphere touches the ground. Up in the air, the shade disappears. We add keyframes for the distance and softness for all three shade effects. Then press U to see them in the timeline. We need to move the keyframes to 5 frames when the sphere touches the ground. Like at 13 frames, we copy and paste the keyframes. And we paste them to 19 frames. Then, at 4 frames, we set the distance and softness to 0. Let's hide the third drop shadow for now. And set the other 4 keyframe values to 0. We copy them and paste them at 6 frames. paste them at 12 frames, at 14 frames, and at 18 frames. Even at a distance to the background, objects usually throw some shade. Let's activate the third drop shadow again and set the distance to 380 at the beginning, the softness to 400. And you can see there's a very soft and distant shadow. Again, at 9 frames, you set the distance to 170, the softness to 230. Lower values. At 16 frames, let's leave the distance at 80, we set the softness to 220. It's a lot of work, but it's very much worth it. Awesome stuff takes time and skills. Make sure to check out my expressions course, link is in the description. On the left side, I've added a video you might like. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye everyone.